Is Topaz currently the most effective and efficient video enhancement software? I still believe it is, and I'll show you why. It's been some time since I reviewed any update from Topaz, and now with version 5 just being released, and with new features and more robust enhancing, this is an important video to show you the strengths of Topaz, both for old footage recovery and for HD footage enhanced to 8K. This first video will compare the previous efforts of different video enhancers, including earlier versions of Topaz, and I'm working with footage that I've previously experimented with in earlier videos, and that's the standard definition 1990s dance band video that I've used before. The second video will use more modern 720p footage and upscale it to 8K. And when that video is published, it'll be in the link above. The SD video for this first example is 720 by 576 at 25 frames per second. And I'm going to upscale it to 1280 by 720 and find the most suitable Topaz settings to make the video as sharp and as clear as possible. Then when we've selected the best settings, I'll export a segment and I'll compare it with previous versions of Topaz and with outputs from Avc Labs and HitPaw Video. But first, let's look at what's new in version 5 of Topaz Video AI. The first feature is when the app is quit, it keeps the workspace that you're currently in with the active previews and the exports. Then it reloads them exactly where you left off, leaving and using that same preview file. The second new feature is the ability to pause and resume exports, even prioritize different queue items on the fly, or even switch to another application without losing any render process. And even after the system reboots, if you've got loss of power or unexpected crashes, your export sessions can be restored. Paused exports are saved to disk, so that frees up the CPU and the GPU utilization. And also, add to those new features, the interface is now cleaner and more user-friendly. But not too much change to make things unfamiliar. They're mostly in the same locations as they were previously, but everything seems to be more intuitive and they're color-toned in line with other Topaz apps. These are the new updated settings. The input relates to the original video file. The resolution is what you're upscaling to. The enhancement section offers a choice of progressive or interlaced. Only very old footage is likely to be interlaced, and even then most of the old camera files will have been updated to progressive anyway. The AI model is the area that you will use to experiment to suit your footage. And we'll see more about that in a minute when I try the different AI models. The input is the state that your original footage is in. As an example, the old SD footage that I'm using here is low quality and may have halos around the edges of the subjects. So we'll try each of those as we work through. There's a choice of recovering detail. But be careful, as that can give an overdone cartoon look that's prominent in some other enhancers, where it can't be removed. This in itself makes Topaz much more realistic than computing examples. And in my mind, this one feature makes Topaz the top choice. Next, you can fix soft focus, but that's not for a standard definition footage, so we won't worry here. The other option that we'll try with our standard definition example is motion blur, as that can help low quality footage. With the new layout, one of the confusing buttons in the Topaz interface is at the bottom. It's the export window, and it doesn't show until you press the bottom button. And that'll have different names depending on the previous export format that you've chosen. However, mostly it will be named ProRes, as that's the default export, and you can change that in the preferences. And you'll see the export settings in this next section where the footage is previewed. There are two buttons, preview and export. I've some current previews that are showing in the preview window, as opposed to the previous exports showing when the export button is selected. To start with a clean slate, I'll remove the previous previews and the exports. Select the preview and click on the three dots. Choose Remove Group or All Groups. I'll do the same with exports. It's obvious that this standard definition footage is old and fuzzy. It can be improved, but don't expect too much. It won't be in any way as clear as even HD footage is from today's cameras. First, we need to select how much we want to increase the size of the image. And as with anything, you can push the envelope too much. You don't drive your Ferrari at top speed, 200 miles per hour, on suburban roads. So don't expect that our shoddy original footage will upscale to 8K. Sure, if footage is normal HD quality, the 8K is a reasonable expectation. And I'll be showing you HD to 8K in the next video. For this current example, I'll increase the size from 720 576 to 1280 720. And you should know that the key to Topaz enhancement is which AI model you choose and how you tweak that model. Each model offers different types of enhancement. For example, if you select the Proteus model, there are auto and manual parameters to consider. If you select the Artemis model, the choices are input options. But let's not get hung up on the details. The key is to select the model most suitable for what you're trying to achieve with your enhancement. So let's look at the options of models. Artemis is for denoise and sharpen. Proteus is for enhancement. Iris improves the face. NYX is for high quality denoising. And Gaia is upscaling at high quality. And Thea is for details and fidelity. Because we've got really shoddy footage, anything with HQ in it is not really suitable. And we should not be worried about improving the really blurred face details. We mostly want to denoise and sharpen. So the model we're going to choose is Artemis. Next, how can we tweak that? And this is where experimentation comes in. First with the input condition, which means the quality of the original. Our footage is bad, so we could select low quality. But also consider that most old SD footage can have a halo effect where images have a white edge. And you can see that in the bass drum in the image. And you've got two different types of halo choices. So even at this stage, we've narrowed down the options to three. Artemis at low quality, medium halo, or strong halo. I'll set the recovery detail to 50 for now. That can be increased if we need to when we've decided on the best input quality. There are further settings, but I'll consider those after trying the first three input settings. Let's try the low quality first. Press the preview button to process 2 seconds. The right-hand B window has got the enhanced image. With the playhead at the beginning of the green segment, press play, which will play the 2 second preview. But I find it's best to review with a still frame by placing the playhead in the middle of the green section and using the split view option. Slide the center line left and right to compare. But you get a much better view by scrolling the image to increase the size and then dragging the image to see the larger view. Check out the background behind the bass player. Also, the new illusion sign at the top. Now let's try the medium halo option. And you'll see the second group appear at the bottom of the screen. You're now comparing 1280 in the A window with the new preview in the B window. There's less change for what we're trying to achieve. And you can compare the change by putting the original 720 in window A. To do that, while you've got the medium halo line selected for window B, Click the line labeled Original to show the original with no features in the A window. Next, the Strong Halo option. Click the green A button and select the medium halo line for comparison. The background's better, but the faces lose detail. So let's try the strong halo with the recovery detail increased. I'll take that up to 85. There's no difference. The only other setting that's likely to help us is the motion blur, and generally that's for fast action scenes, but maybe it's useful for this lower frame rate of 25 frames per second. I'll try motion to blur. A major difference in the face detail. As a final experiment, I'll try the low quality with the motion to blur and the 85 recovery detail. Bingo! A much sharper result with less grain. I'll export a minute of that now for comparisons with the previous reviews for Avc, HitPaw, and an earlier version of Topaz. First, the comparison with Avc and the older version of Topaz. And to see my video that directly compares those two enhancers, click the eye above. Next, the results from HitPaw Video Enhancer. It does bring the video to life with its color conversion, which is unique to HitPaw. And see my video comparing Topaz and HitPaw Video Enhancer, click the eye above. But even with the color change, the HitPaw video is not as realistic as the latest version 5 of Topaz. HitPaw tends to over-enhance to give that cartoon look to faces. And finally, this is the result showing Topaz version 5, which trumps them all for clarity and upscaling. And my next video will show Topaz Video AI, and it will enhance 720p footage to 8K. Please like and subscribe, and make sure you press the bell to be reminded when the next Topaz video is published. Thanks for watching.